Hello everyone, this is Baldwin Eng from Microsoft. Today I'm going to share with you some of the Windows 10 remote learning tools from our Microsoft partners that will make your STEAM lessons fun and engaging. At Microsoft, our Windows 10 team is working hard to provide personalized learning through powerful devices and education app experiences that are powered by Windows Ink, Touch, and Windows 10 in S mode. During this session, we're going to highlight apps that are available in the Microsoft Store, the App Store for Windows 10, including Core 3D, KANO, Sketchup, Rhythmic Village, and the Windows Calculator. So stick around and don't go away. All right, thank you so much, Martin, for joining us from Corinth by Lifelike. So please take it away and show us more about how to make science lessons engaging.
Thanks so much for inviting us, Baldwin. This is an exciting opportunity. So let me show you a sneak peek of Corinth, the 3D learning app that makes it really super exciting to learn science through 1,500 interactive 3D models, all verified by top universities and integrated with Office 365 and different part of the Microsoft learning portfolio. So let me show you an example of one of the 3D models that we have in our science or in K-12 science library, which is coronavirus 3D model, which is the first of its kind for educational purposes. Using my Windows 10 touchscreen PC, you can see me interacting with the model, highlighting different parts. There's a number of the other features like sharing and interaction. So let me show you how you can use all those powerful images and models in your own preparations, whether we talk about presentations, assignments, science reports, and so on. So I've prepared a piece about plant reproduction. It's a PowerPoint deck, and thanks to Corinth screenshots add-in, I can use all those images that I made in the Corinth app and simply insert them in my deck. So you see a number of different images I've taken before. I've used one more, and just after I switch to slideshow view, I can always open the 3D model to make my presentation or assignment interactive, engaging, and highly visual. You can find Corinth 3D app in the Microsoft Store. You can find us at corinth3d.com. And remember, keep your teaching and learning really interactive, visual, and engaging. Thanks so much for your attention.
Thank you so much, Martin, for joining us. All right, Logan, thank you so much for joining us from KANO. We really look forward to how your KANO can teach kids about STEM. So take it away, please.
Thanks so much, Baldwin. Hi, everyone. My name is Logan Hickel. I work with KANO Computing, and I'm an education marketing specialist here. Today, I just wanted to kind of go over a few apps that we offer to educators and to students to increase those STEM learning outcomes in the classroom. First up, we're going to show you a little example of KANO code. KANO code is block-based coding, similar to Scratch or Blockly. Many of you are very familiar with that. We then also offer MakeArt. MakeArt is typed-based coding, but it's still color-coded and it offers tooltips and video tutorials in there for the students. And then thirdly, we have How Computers Work. And How Computers Work is a set of modules that teach students how that device operates. That way they understand what they're doing on the device and can troubleshoot that device. So I'm going to hop over here to KANO code. So this is KANO code on Windows 10. This can be found for free on the Microsoft Store, and this app can also be accessed via world.kano.me. That's our online platform, which houses KANO code and MakeArt. So here you can see a set of challenges. We do have challenges that are part of our KANO Club subscription platform, but we do have free challenges for the students as well. If you go into the challenges, it walks you through step by step on what you're doing. So as you can see, this is the tray here, and it's just very simple, one block. It's going to have beacons that slowly show them what to do to change the color of the background and also to drag out blocks. Obviously, this gets more and more difficult as they get further and further in those challenges. Next up, I wanted to show Make Art. So Make Art, like I said, is typed-based programming, but again, it's still visual, color-coded, and still helps them with those tooltips. So you can see here, this is Make Art. And again, this is accessible via world.kano.me. So it's telling me here to type background blue and then color yellow. So very similar to Kano code, but now we're transitioning them off block coding into typed-based coding, but it's still simple commands. And then I'm going to draw a circle. And I completed Sunny Day. So once again, very easy, very kind of step-by-step for that student. And if I go in here, you can see a couple challenges for the students as well. And each of them have a series of challenges within those packs. Thank you so much for your time. Again, my name is Logan Hickel with KANO Computing. If you need some more information, you can head over to kano.me/education. Thanks so much for your time.
Great. Thank you so much, Logan, for joining us from KANO. All right, Tori, thank you so much for joining us from SketchUp for Schools. So why don't you give us a quick lightning tour about how you can make STEAM classes exciting?
Be happy to. Thanks, Baldwin, and hello, educators. My name's Tori Hassan, and I work for SketchUp as the product manager of our K-12 product, SketchUp for Schools. If you're looking to bring 3D modeling into your classroom, SketchUp for Schools is just the tool to help you out. It's available for free to K-12 schools worldwide, and it's a modeling application that can be found both in the Microsoft Store as a Windows 10 app, as well as directly on the web at edu.sketchup.com. The app lets you and your students log in using your school accounts, which makes it easy to save SketchUp projects right alongside all of your other schoolwork. Depending on the classes you teach, SketchUp for Schools can be used to model something as small as the anatomy of a cell or as large as an entire cityscape. At SketchUp, we believe in 3D for everyone. And with SketchUp for Schools, we've worked hard to make modeling accessible to all ages. So now if you'll join me, I'd like to take you on a quick tour of some of the great things in our app. Once you've logged in, getting started with SketchUp is super easy. Our curriculum tab provides quick access to a variety of curriculum-based lesson plans that are suited to all skill levels. You can follow along with our written lesson plans or use our in-app videos that let you pause and rewind at your own speed as you model along with our instructor. If you prefer learning on your own, then you can simply go in and start modeling. If you need help with any specific tools, then you can simply click that tool and then open up our instructor panel where you'll get both a visual and written description of that tool and how to use it. Maybe you can't find a tool in the menu. This is where our search bar comes in handy. Here you can find all tools related to your search terms, as well as any applicable keyboard shortcuts. And best of all, both this toolbar and SketchUp for Schools are available in 12 different languages. So if you're learning in English, Spanish, or French, we've got you covered. Finally, we also know that 3D printing is becoming a super important part of curriculum across the world, and we wanted to help you and your students make sure that your models are ready to print. Using our Solid Inspector tool, ensuring a model is solid before sending it to print is as easy as selecting it and running it through our inspector. Even if an inspection fails, like it has in this case, you can use the hidden geometry or the X-ray functions to find any errors or gaps in the model. And then fix these errors, the model is solid and it's ready to print. These tools help prevent errors and help you and your students troubleshoot before ever sending to a printer. Our goal is to help make 3D modeling accessible and functional in your classroom, and we're happy to continue learning and growing alongside our EDU community. Thank you for your continued support and happy sketching.
All right, Joel, please go ahead and give us a quick demo on how to make music education fun. Take it away.
Okay, wonderful. Hi, I'm Joel, and I'm very happy to demo one of our Windows 10 product. It's basically one app of five apps of the World of Music suite, where we focus everything in making music very fun in classroom, but also at home. So let me jump right into it. So today I will demo our app related with rhythm and sight reading, because in Rhythmic Village, you will explore the Rhythmics, the funny sounding Rhythmics. It's all about the note values, which are the basics in sight reading or reading sheet music. So kids can develop their rhythmic senses and improve their performance skills with any percussion instrument. They will meet this rhythmics and they will have a lot of fun with them. So let's jump right into it. I will show you the first levels. So in the first level, you have the hear and drum it level. It's about hearing a sequence and play along or play after it. But in this case, you can use the device. Or you can activate the microphone and play along by clapping or by using a real instrument. In the other levels, you will have, for example, let me jump right into it. You have the fire dance levels. It's here's more about timing. It's like in tap games where you have to play at the right time so that you can rescue our rhythmics. Let me do it. Let me do it with clapping along. Also have levels like the Buffalo Run, where it's about identifying the right sequence. So it's a multiple choice level, but beautiful animated. If you made it wrong, you have immediate feedback, and it's all about listening to the rhythm and to select the right sequence. Yeah, that is a different way, a joyful way to explore rhythm in the 21st century. And we are very happy to offer that together with Microsoft. So thank you so much for your time. Hope to see you very soon in the world of music. Stay safe. Let's class splash.
Thank you, Joa. Appreciate it. All right, Dave, thank you so much for joining us in this ISTE session on Windows 10 app. So take it away and show us the power of Windows Calculator.
Thanks, Baldwin. So I'm Dave Gerhaki. I'm a senior PM lead working on apps that ship with Windows. And as Baldwin said, we're going to talk a little bit about Windows Calculator. So if you're a fan of Windows, you've certainly used Windows Calculator before, but you may not be aware of all of the powerful functionality built into this tiny app. Instead of talking about it, I'm going to dive right into a quick demo to show it in action. So here you see the default view for Calculator that you know and love. But if you go up to the navigation button up here, you can unlock all of the additional functionality that we have included as well. There is a fully functional scientific calculator for handling more advanced math. There's a programmer calculator for some of the more niche functionality when learning concepts in computer programming. And then we have unit converters of all type, from currency to length, volume, and speed. The currency converter works offline as well, which is great in limited bandwidth environments. But what I really want to spend a little bit of time on is the brand new graphing mode that we introduced recently into the app. Now, of course, you can plot some basic equations, like y equals x squared, and you can plot multiple equations at the same time. Something that's kind of neat is you can include variables. So if you are teaching something like y equals mx plus b, you can plot those. And then in the UI right underneath here, you can tweak those variables in real time to see how changing them impact the graph. So let's take a look at y equals x squared. Here in this basic example, both the y-intercept and the x-intercept are both zero, and you can see that there are some other key graph features as well. Now, y equals x squared is not particularly interesting, but depending on the graph, you can use this to learn more about the equations. So that is all the time we have to talk about Calculator today. Now, the graphing functionality that you saw is built in on Windows 10 version 20H2 or newer. Or if you are on Windows 10 version 2004, you can unlock this functionality by going to the store and getting the latest version of Windows Calculator as an update. Thanks.
Thank you so much, Dave. Appreciate your time. All right. Now that you've seen the five different Windows 10 app demos, please be sure to check out our Windows 10 devices site. Also, check out some of the remote teaching tips from our Mac Center, as well as the education store for Windows 10 apps. Thank you so much for your time. We'll see you soon.